Hi, and welcome to our Cinema ProCams tutorial. We're going to go through some of the terminology of Cinema ProCams before we actually get into creating cameras, just to kind of talk a little bit about what you can do with the different features of Cinema ProCams. So the first thing we want to do is just drag our ProCams package into our an empty Unity project, no different than if you were to buy from the store. And once this is open, we just want to kind of go through a couple of the folders. We bring over some image effects, which are only going to work inside of Unity Pro. So depth of field and that kind of thing are the features that only Unity Pro is going to support, but you can still use Cinema ProCams with Unity Free. In our flyout, we can either create a new ProCam, a 3D ProCam, and there is also an option to refresh lens data, which is a more advanced feature that we'll talk about later in the tutorial. We've included a sample scene with Cinema ProCams under the Cinema Suite folder, Example Scene folder. It's called Stereo 3D. And we're going to open this up, and when you open it, you can see that there's some sample shapes here, and the shapes and the way they're configured allow us to test the camera in different situations and different configurations. But we just want to talk some terminology. So I'm just going to reorient the view so that we can kind of get a better view of the camera looking at these boxes. And when I select a camera, you can actually see a bunch of information pop up. These are called gizmo lines, and these lines do everything from show what the camera is seeing to showing the range of the depth of field of the camera, what the camera is focusing on. And if you have a stereo 3D camera, and in this case by default that's what this scene is using, you'll also see red gizmo lines that represent 3D, and we'll get into that later in the tutorial. The outer lines are called the field of view, so this is what the current lens on the camera can see. The near blue line at 9 feet 4 inches away is the near limit of the depth of field that the camera can see. And that's 9 feet 4 from the nodal point of the camera. Then we have a far point of 25 feet, that's called the far limit of the depth of field. And whatever's in between the near limit and the far limit is your actual depth of field range, what the camera can see and what is going to be in focus for the camera. So in this case, the cylinder and the boxes will be in focus, but the sphere and the cylinder farther away outside of that 25 foot range won't be. So I'm just going ahead and getting rid of the 3D effects so we can just kind of work with a single camera and continue to talk terminology. When you look in game mode, this is exactly what the camera is seeing. And again, you can see that representation where the sphere is in focus, the boxes are in focus. But this sphere and this cylinder are out of focus because they're outside of that depth of field range that the camera is seeing. So we can adjust focal length lenses. We can adjust the aperture. We're using a Cook Prime TI lens kit that we've done all our research on, so it's all compliant to real world standards. We can name the camera. We can, I'm just going to just dock this over here so we can get a better view of what the camera is seeing while we're working. It works a lot better if you have two monitors. We can adjust the aperture of the camera. Before you do that, you have to make sure that your game mode is in standalone. And now you can see that the lenses automatically adjust depending on the aspect ratio or film format that's chosen. So you can see as I toggle through, we have full aperture 16:9, which is your standard digital format. And you can see again the lenses change and behave depending on the aspect ratio chosen. This is more of that cinematic film format. Then we have anamorphic, which is used in movies like Star Wars, Lord of the Rings, and that kind of thing. So all these are real-world compliant to the lens kit, and all those calculations are automatically built into the software. So you know what you're choosing is exactly what you're going to get if you were to use a real-world camera with a Cook lens. We also have the option to view in 2K or 4K. If you do have a 2K or 4K monitor and you dock the game window to that monitor, we give you the option to give a true representation of what the camera is going to see at that resolution. but we'll keep it on standard for now. We give the ability to attach to a rig, so if you have a model inside of your Unity project and you want to attach a camera to the end of that model, we give you the option to do that. And then under lens data, you can see that we have many different lens sizes from 12mm all the way up to 180mm. And when I change the lens, you can see that the depth of field limits will change as well, the near and far limit, depending on the lens selected. And again, this is all built into the real world behaviors of what the lens actually does. So switching back to 14mm, you can see now that more of the objects are in focus because that far depth of field has changed. If I go up to something like 25mm, then it's really narrowed the depth of field and only the cylinder is in focus, and you can see that everything else is not. So playing around with focal lengths as well as aperture settings can really give different effects and feels to your Unity project and whatever you're trying to capture. And again, with the 32mm lens, you can see how the that depth of field has changed, and also the field of view, of course, is changing depending on the lens that is chosen. Now, we're putting it back on 18mm, and let's just kind of go over what aperture does. So right now we have an f-stop of 1.4. If we go all the way up to an f-stop of 22 or higher, again, this changes the effect of the depth of field. So in this case, by going with an f-stop of 2.8, you can see that that far limit is so far away that really everything in your scene for this particular lens is going to be in focus. Just keep in mind that the smaller the aperture size, the smaller the depth of field, and the larger the aperture size, the larger the depth of field. Switching to a 35mm lens, but with the same f-stop value, you can see that the near and far depth of field have changed quite dramatically, and they're now within the object set. And I'm just scrolling through here and showing the effect of changing all the different aperture values and how that depth of field is affected. And we have that live preview constantly happening, not in just the Unity Inspector, but in the game window as well. We can also focus on different objects in our scene. We have an option inside of Unity, and the yellow line is what the camera is focused on. If I select the click subject to focus option, and then I clicked an object in my scene, you can see that the camera is changing its focal point now to that actual object, and that's going to affect everything. That's going to affect your near and far limit of your depth of field, and it's going to affect your lens behavior. So that's also built into the software. So all the different things that are affected when you are working with a lens is the focal length of the lens, the aperture of the lens, and what you're focusing on all have an effect on how that lens behaves. So this concludes our tutorial on the basics and some terminology on Cinema Pro Cams. In our next tutorial, we're going to take a look at creating cameras from scratch and also modifying camera settings inside of your Unity project. Thanks for watching.